Hello friends, my name is Gokul and in this video I'm going to explain you panch kosha, that means five energy seeds. And here you can see panch kosha. Panch means five and kosha means seeds. Just try to understand this concept. And this is very, very important concept in yoga philosophy. So first of all, look at this, a kind of figure. So I have just created it. So you can see I have mentioned five energy states or the five bodies. First of all, a human being is able to experience five dimensions of their existence. So these are five dimensions. The outer one is annamaya kosha. The next one is pranamaya kosha. The next one is manomaya kosha. Next one is vigyanmaya kosha. Next one is anandmaya kosha. So these are the five states or a human being can experience all these things. And the other thing is that we practice different yogic practices. So they have a purpose, because these yogic practices just influence in these panch koshas. So just understand this. And these koshas are gross to subtle. Means you can see the superficial is annamaya kosha. This is gross. But as compared to this annamaya kosha, the pranamaya kosha is subtle. Okay, now we start from the annamaya kosha. This annamaya kosha is known as food shape. Okay, because it is totally dependent on food. So that's why when we eat and drink, this body just grows up, because it is dependent on food and water and the other things. And if we don't eat, so definitely what is going to be happen? Our body, our physical body is going to be weaker. Okay, but the other thing is that in this annamaya kosha, there is energy as well. Okay, we eat food and other things, but all these stuff contains actually prana or the energy. Because there is a concept that we have prana, that's why we exist in this universe. If we don't have prana, so we cannot exist. That's why even if it is dependent on the food and the water and the other liquids, but energy is here in this animal motion. And by the practice of asana, we just try to influence this annamaya kosha. Okay, we do cleansing practices. We call it shatkamas as well. So we have different cleansing techniques or the shatkamas. The shatkamas and the asana just influence this annamaya kosha. And by the practice of these, we just try to clean this annamaya kosha. Because if there are impurities in this physical body, so our consciousness remains here. Okay, and that's why if there are impurities and the pranas would not settle enough, so that the prana can enter into the next level, that is the pranamaya kosha. And because of that, our consciousness remains into this annamaya kosha, and what happens then? We only think about this physical body. And because of that, if anybody have consciousness in this physical body, they just eat, drink and sleep. And these kind of people are dhanmani. And the reason is what? Because the pranas are not subtle enough and the prana cannot enter into the next level. And because of that, their consciousness appeared in this animal portion. The next one is pranamaya portion. And this is very, very important portion. And it is completely made of energy. Okay. And the pranayamas actually influence this pranamaya portion. Okay, so by the practice of asana and satkarma, we purify this and then we practice pranayama and we directly influence this pranayama kosha and makes the pranas finite here and subtle, so that the prana can just move in the deeper level and the outer level as well. Okay, so here you can see here I have mentioned something here. Breath is just the external manifestation. Okay, so that means because we know that there is a concept in yoga philosophy, prana is everywhere. Prana is what? Prana is energy. And prana is responsible for everything, for the existence of everything, for the existence of us, for the existence of yours, for aeroplane, for trees, for stone, for everything. So if there is no prana, there is no existence. So similarly, our breath is just a manifestation of prana. Means the force, the vital force which is just controlling our breath is nothing but the prana. Similarly, the thoughts which are created in our mind, the force which is working behind that is nothing but the prana. So here, what we are doing, we are just regulating the breath in pranayama. And in this way, we are just trying to control the prana, because our just prana just fluctuating. Okay, and because of this fluctuation in the prana, our just mind fluctuates. So this is a kind of technique, pranayama, through which we are just learning a technique so that we can control the mind. Okay, so the pranayama practice directly influences the pranayama kosha, makes the prana finer and subtle, but indirectly influences the manomaya kosha. Okay, so this is very, very important, and we can say that pranayama kosha or pranayama is the key to get success in the spiritual path. So by the practice of pranayama, what we are doing, we are just trying to purify the manomaya kosha as well. And if we purify this manomaya kosha, then what happens? You can see purification of the manomaya kosha results clarity of the thoughts, balanced expression of emotions, ego and the intellect. So nowadays in the present time, people doesn't have the balanced mind. And because of that, what problem they have? They don't have clarity of thoughts. They don't have balanced emotions. They have ego as well. They don't have intellect, good intellect. So if you practice pranayama, it indirectly work on the manomaya kosha. Because recently we discussed what? We discussed that prana is responsible, the energy which is flowing within our body, and this is what the concept of the yoga philosophy. Prana is just flowing everywhere, and it is responsible for everything, every kind of movement. So there is fluctuation in your thoughts. That means your mind is fluctuating, but who is responsible for that? The prana. Similarly, breath is a like manifestation. So if we voluntarily control our breath, we are controlling the mind. And the result would be here, a clarity of the thoughts. And by the practice of pranayama, pranas become subtle. Now the prana are able to enter into the next realm. But before that, if your consciousness has become subtle enough and it is able to enter into the pranayama kosha, so what tendency you will show? You will feel energetic. And if I will show you the example, like the sports persons. If you will see sports persons, they are energetic. They are ambitious because their consciousness here in this pranayama kosha. If I talk about the manomaya kosha, if I relate this manomaya kosha, so these kind of people have analytical mind. Okay, like big scientists, big experts in their field, because somehow their consciousness can enter into this manomaya kosha. That's why they have analytical mind, and they can think deeper in a particular subject. So this is what the tendency of the manomaya kosha. Now you can think that the scientists and the big experts are not practicing the yoga or any kind of yoga practice. Yes, this is right. But in yoga we believe in the previous birth theory as well. So somehow maybe it is their past karmas, and because of that they are able to enter into this manomaya kosha. That's why they can think deeply in a particular subject. Okay, now after this, if prana has become settled by the practice of pranayama, and if we do the meditation, so pranas become more subtle, and then the pranas can enter into the vigyanmaya kosha. And if this happens, so what is the result? Because the vigyanmaya kosha is related to the subconscious mind. Okay, and we know that our subconscious mind is very, very powerful. And that means if pranas can enter into this vigyanmaya kosha, that is the fourth kosha, so what is going to be happen? understanding downloads. Okay, we would get the intuition power. We can predict the things, these kind of things, because our subconscious mind is very, very powerful. And this vigyanmaya kosha is related or connected to subconscious mind and the unconscious mind. Okay, so this is what happens with the vigyanmaya kosha. And now you can get access the memories of your past life as well, because this vigyanmaya kosha is very, very powerful. And this is what the science says in the present time. And the last one is anandmaya kosha, and this anandmaya kosha is known as the bliss seat. Okay, so that is causal or transcendental body. So we don't know when prana or how will enter here, but yes, if you are meditating 4 hours in a day, so then someday the prana become more subtle, and suddenly one day your pranas will be able to enter into this anandmaya kosha. And if this happens, you achieve the bliss state, a state where you get stability of the mind. So this is just the concept, but if you just observe this figure, pranayama is the key. Okay, so if you are practicing pranayama, you can awaken the dormant centers of your brain. Okay, so that is the case. Now, the other thing is that according to the Yoga Sutra of Patanjali, there are 8 limbs. Okay, so and in that 8 limbs, we have the Pratyahara as well. I'll show you. So pranayama control the mind, and for Pratyahara is what? Pratyahara is controlling your senses. Because if you want to sit for meditation, you should have control on your senses. Because if your senses are involved in the external subject, it would be very, very difficult for you to do meditation. So that's why Patanjali has mentioned Pratyahara, that is sense control. And after that, he has mentioned the dharana, that is concentration. Okay, so for this, for achieving the Pratyahara state, you should have control over your mind. So pranayama is the key. Okay, and after Pratyahara, the next stage is Pratyahara. The next stage is dharana. Dharana is the concentration. Okay, then you can achieve the dharana, and if you are doing concentration, that is dharana, you will achieve the state of meditation. And if you keep meditating, then one day you will experience the samadhi state. So this is nothing but the awakening. So this is just the whole concept. Okay, and I think now the things has been cleared by our practicing different yogic practices and what purpose they have. So this is the whole concept about the yogic practices. So if you like my video, so please comment on the video, share, and don't forget to subscribe my channel. And there is a bell button, and just click on it so that you can get my notifications. Have a nice day. Goodbye.